On the 9th of May 1997, a healthy 3-year-old boy in Hong Kong developed fever, a sore throat and cough. The child's symptoms persisted and a week later he was hospitalized. His illness progressed, so he was admitted to the intensive care unit. On May 21st, the child died from acute respiratory distress. This is the first reported case of a human being affected by bird flu. Bird flu is caused by a virus, and this virus is found in wild birds. Interestingly, the wild birds are not affected by the virus. But wild birds pass on the virus to birds we humans raise for food, such as chicken and ducks. And these birds get very sick with the virus. And since many people have close contact with birds raised on farms, this deadly virus is passed on to people. Now, this video is not about bird flu. However, as this example demonstrates, ever so often we come across a new and dangerous disease. And the world needs professionals to uncover causes, find solutions, and suggest methods to prevent infection. If solutions are not found, destruction can be on a very large scale. For example, in the year 1918, Spanish flu killed close to 100 million people, or 5% of the world's population. Thankfully, there are professionals involved in this area of work, and one such professional is the epidemiologist. Epidemiologists research the causes and consequences of illness and disease. They collect and analyze data and report their findings to health practitioners, policymakers, and the public. By determining how and why diseases and illnesses occur, they help prevent them from spreading. Their research also helps in the creation of public health policies and disease management strategies around the world. To become an epidemiologist, you need at least a master's degree from an accredited institution. Most epidemiologists have a master's degree in epidemiology or a related field such as public health. Now, in order to qualify for a master's degree, many institutes ask for a bachelor's degree in a health-related discipline. However, some institutes are more flexible and also allow students with bachelor's degrees in other disciplines such as engineering, statistics, and arts. A math, science, and computers background in high school is also recommended. And as I keep repeating in most of our videos, it's a good idea to go to a university or college website and check requirements. Or if you can, go directly to an institute and talk to students and teachers to get a clear idea of what is needed. Some of the places where epidemiologists work are government agencies, private research organizations, pharmaceutical companies, hospitals, and universities. So what are some of the activities epidemiologists are involved in? Epidemiologists generally work in clean, well-lit offices and laboratories. On an average day, an epidemiologist may be involved in data analysis that might shed light on some current concern. They may occasionally fly to remote areas to help monitor the outbreak of a new deadly virus. They also educate healthcare workers, patients, and the public about infections and diseases. Epidemiologists are sometimes referred to as medical detectives. So if you like math and the idea of unraveling the mysteries behind diseases appeals to you, this is a career path you should consider. Furthermore, as of today's date, the job outlook for this role is bright. And one reason is that many governments are using epidemiologists for preventive healthcare. This means preventing diseases in the first place rather than curing them once they occur. So good luck.